place. Man, I can feel it in here right now. Thank God. Man, I can feel it in here right now. And God is sending in a fresh anointing. And a fresh anointing. Amen. The rest of that song said, one thing have I desired, or one thing I desire is to dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen.
And I just want to dwell.
Yes.
But all that's going on in the world, I just want to dwell. And everybody is seeking after this and seeking after that. Oh, but I just want more of God. Anybody want more of God?
Yeah.
Man, I just want more. You know, I want so much and so tired. I just can't see nobody else. Praise God. I mean, you get so lost in God to you can't see your persecutors. You can't see the storm. You're just going to get so lost in God that no matter what the obstacle is, you yet have a grip on God. And so many people have lost their joy. And their joy, that joy that they once had, so many people have lost it. Amen. We ought to go back and get our joy.
Amen.
Amen. Lord, I just want you. The scripture says, amen, this is not my message that I have to prepare for today, but in Psalms 51 and 10 says, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. My God. Amen. This is to cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me.
Hallelujah.
Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Oh, uphold me with thy free spirit.
Yes.
My God, it said, let me say, cast me not away. Oh, I just don't want to be cast away. My God. Oh, with everything that's turning away. My God. Oh, I just don't want to be cast away.
Yes.
And I got tears in my eyes, and I'm filled up because so many people are just being cast away.
Jesus.
So many people are just giving up without even thinking about their soul. But oh, if I were you, I would cry with every fiber of my being.
Yes,
my
Lord.
God. That God, you just restore me.
Yes,
this year, this is the first youth service of the year 2012.
Yes.
And I want to go through this year. You ought to have in your mind, I want to go through this year with joy.
Yes.
God.
Yes.
The joy that I used to have, God restored back.
Hallelujah.
The fervor that I once had, not just youth, but adults as well. Everybody, the fervor that I once had, God, I need it back.
Yes.
I see the onslaught of the enemy. God, will you just restore it back to me? I don't want to be cast away. It's to cast me not away from thy presence and take not thy Holy Spirit from me, my God. Don't take your spirit away from me.
Hallelujah.
Oh, I can't live without your spirit.
Yes, Lord.
I can't live without your presence, my God. Oh, you ever been in a place and you just couldn't feel God's presence? Oh, I've been there before I was my age now, before I was preaching, I sat right over there in the front pew. An apostle was preaching a message, and he said, you know what? God is going to withdraw himself from somebody. God is going to take himself away. And I said, my God. I said, God, please don't withdraw yourself from me.
Hallelujah.
I said, God, I'll do whatever I have to do, but God, don't take your spirit
Hallelujah.
Away from me. I got down on my knees right here in this corner, right by the chair. I remember it like it was yesterday. And I said, God, don't take your spirit away from me. Don't forsake me. He said, somebody, God gonna give up on somebody.
That's right. That's what he said.
And I said, God, don't,
glory,
my God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, somebody's not getting it. Y'all better get serious about God.
Yes, Lord.
Because God is getting ready to give up on somebody.
Yes, Lord.
I feel like God getting ready to just turn you over. Why? Because he's been chiming and chiming, and you have been rejecting and rejecting.
Yes,
God is getting tired of people rejecting his mercy.
Yes, Lord.
God is getting tired of people walking away and giving up on him. Somebody ought to cry out.
Hallelujah.
If your children won't cry out, you cry out.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, if your husband won't cry out, you cry out. If your wife won't cry out, you cry out.
Hallelujah.
My God, the factual fervent prayer of a righteous man.
Yes.
Very much. me.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Lord, cast me not away from thy presence. And take not the Holy Spirit away from me. If there's anything down there that's good, that means anything, God, I need you to rekindle. I need you to relight that fire that's within me. My God, you ought to ask yourself, how long will I wear my grave clothes? How long am I going to wear my grave clothes? It's time to shake them things off. My God, it created in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me. Somewhere along the line, my spirit got messed up. Somewhere along the line, my spirit has tapped into another spirit, and I've allowed it to corrupt the thing that was in me that was right. But my God, the reason why you're here today is because there's still something there. There's still something there. And God is saying, I'm ready to light that fire right now. Praise God. I'm ready to shower down and make you grow right now. Would you just open up to me? Will you just open up to me? The psalmist saw the need to cry out to God. The psalmist saw the need for restoration. My God, there's a need for restoration. Anybody need to be restored? Praise God. There's a need for restoration. And if you don't want God to turn away, you don't want God to turn a deaf ear on you, you better ask God for restoration. I need to be restored. I need to be cleaned up. My God, you ever see when somebody restores something that's old, like stainless steel or chrome, they take a little something and they polish it. And they rub it down until the scratches and all the fingerprint and everything comes out. My God, you need to ask God to wash you down. Polish you up. Get all the scratches out. Why? Because there's some blemishes there. There's something there that's putting a separation between me and God. And I'm tired of being the one left out. Oh, I don't want to come in and thank you, but I want to be real for this thing. I want to come in and I'm tired just because everybody else throw their hand up. So I don't be left out. I'm going to throw my hand up. I want to be real. Hallelujah. I want to be real. When I shout hallelujah, I want it to be real. I'm tired of thinking I can't make it on my thing. And God, make me real. I want real joy. I want real power. I want real anointing. He said, I give you power and authority. God, I want the real thing. I want to be real when I cry out. I want to be real when I get that on my knees. I want to be real when I'm
hungry.
Oh, my God. When the tears fall up in my eyes, God, I want it to be real. I want to be real. I want to be real. Real. My God, if I gotta walk by myself, let me be real by myself. If I got to sit by myself, let me be real by myself. If nobody talks to me, let me be quiet by myself. Because when I'm quiet to the world, my joy is loud in the ears. Hallelujah. Let me be real, real, real. God is seeking after somebody that's real. Real, praise God. In order for me to be real, I need you to change some things within me.
Yes.
I need you to change my outlook on life. Hallelujah. Yes. I need you to change my whole disposition.
Yes.
I need you to change the way I look. Yes. Change the way I act.
Yes.
Let me tell you something about the Spirit of God. Oh, you can tell when the Spirit of God comes on an individual because they just start to light up. All that darkness starts to fade away. They just start to light up because they gave into the power of God. Somebody ought to give into the power of God. Oh, tomorrow's not promised. Oh, the next day's not promised. But today, right now, give us this day.
Yes.
Our daily bread. And I heard somebody say, this is the day that the Lord has made. Oh, while you have this day, I'm going to reach out with everything I got. I'm crying with everything I got. That song that they sing really, really rang down in me because it should take me back to the place where I first received you. Some of them forgot their way back. Some of them forgot their way back. They've been gone so long that I'm not talking about just out in the world. Some of them sitting right in church and have been gone so long.
Oh, yes.
Oh, Lord, I forgot the way it's still to fill your presence.
Hallelujah.
like you did on the third day.
Hallelujah.
How you got up with all power. Lord, I need you to get up with power in me.
Yeah.
I need you when you get up to shake some things loose.
Hallelujah.
I need you when you get up in me to break some chains.
Oh, yes.
God, I need you when you get up in me to change my life. God, I need you to change my life.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I'm right at the eve of destruction. God, when you get up in me, don't make me a slave, my God.
Oh, yes.
Just like the potter, I want you to break me down and make me new. God, before I am
my God,
there's something wrong in my life. There's something that's in me that's just not right. Only you can break me down and make me over.
Oh, yes.
Anybody on the potter's with me? One more. God.
Hallelujah.
And Lord God is ready right now.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Somebody. Go ahead and take the word and start pointing the finger. That is you. It was not for me. This is that one. You're the very one that needs to be pricked by the word of God. You're the very one that's pointing the finger at somebody else. Your conscience is being seared with a hot iron. Go ahead and point the finger and walk out of here like it was just another thing, another word to keep us at 3 o'clock. Go ahead and let it think that. But as for me and my house, we got to do it. We got to try. We gotta fix up and fix it all.